This episode of Brew Chat with the Scots is brought to you by Bull City Homebrew. Bull City Homebrew has all the equipment and ingredients you need to get the most out of your hobby. Stop by their store on Highway 54 in Durham and check them out online at bullcityhomebrew.com.
I'm Scott.
And I'm Scott. We're from Bull City Homebrew. We teach brew school here. And we're going to talk to you today about the difference between extract brewing and all grain brewing.
Most people get started brewing by using extract, which is malted barley in two different forms. We have the liquid form, which is known as LME, liquid malt extract. And you can see how thick and syrupy it is.
And delicious.
And delicious too. You can put this on waffles, look at that thing. Thick, syrupy, and delicious. And there's also dried malt extract, known as DME. So when you're making extract, you're putting these ingredients in the pot, adding the hops, boiling for an hour, and then you're good to go. Go ahead, I was gonna segue over to you, a little bit different though when you're doing an all grain batch.
Yeah, so basically, new brewers will use this to make what we call wort. Wort is basically just a fancy term for unfermented beer. And when they make their wort, the malt extract, whether it's in dry form or in liquid form, is what adds sugar to the wort. Sugar is the thing that the yeast are eventually going to eat and turn into delicious alcohol. Yeah. And carbon dioxide is a byproduct. So normally when breweries make beer, they will start with not malt extract, but they will actually start with the full grain, which is what you can see here. This is called two-row, and they will crush this and basically make an enormous batch of oatmeal with it. They will typically heat the water to about 150 degrees, add the grain to it, stir it in, let it sit for an hour, and basically what happens is that will convert the enzymes in that grain into sugar, and then they will take the runoff from that, and that becomes their wort. But the process takes a lot longer to make wort from crushed grain than it does from extract. Extract basically bypasses the step of making that big bowl of oatmeal and lets you get right to boiling it and adding the hops and all those things.
And homebrewers will use what's called a mash tun, which is usually a converted cooler to make their mash to put the 15 pounds of grain or however big the grain bill is to do all grain brewing. Some of the pros and cons of each, if you're using extract, a lot of people like it better because it's so quick and it's very easy. You can do it in probably less than 2 hours, although it usually takes us longer because of our beer drinking and lollygagging. Truth be told,
we would never do that.
Oh yeah, we never. Maybe once. It takes a lot less time. The downside is it's about twice the cost of all grain brewing, and you really don't have the control of the mash profile and all the things that are going into your beer and the final product as you would if you're doing all grain brewing. The good part of all grain brewing is you have that extra control. And you have, I see some people think that it's a downside because it takes about 4 hours. I think that's an upside because it's more time to drink and lollygag. For those of you who do that, we don't do that. Right down to business. It's all serious up in here. But for those who like to do that sort of thing, for those not as serious people like us, then you have more time. And it's also about half the cost, which is a big plus too. So all grain brewing, it takes a lot longer, about twice the cost, but it's a big savings, or you have more control over your final product, and that's what a lot of people like about all grain brewing.
But like Scott said, relaxing and enjoying your homebrew is serious business.
It's a good thing to do. There aren't a lot of things I'd rather do on a Friday after a weekend afternoon.
But it sure makes it a lot easier to get started in homebrewing when you have something like malt extract available to cut your brew day in half.
And one last word about the extract versus all grain. There are a lot of people who kind of thumb their nose at the extract people. And Scott and I do both. We do the extract and all grain brewing. But a lot of people tend to turn their nose up at extract, saying it's, you know, it's not as good, it's not as old school, it's not as real as it should be, it's not as good as all grain brewing. And it's been my experience that I've tasted some really, really, really good extract stuff that if they hadn't told me it was extract, I wouldn't have known. What are your experiences with that?
Yeah, no, absolutely. If you've got your process right and you're doing all the things that the recipe calls for and you're following all the rules of home brewing, you can make a batch with extract that tastes just as good as off-the-shelf beer.
And it's nice to, with the, as much as I love all grain brewing, and I do, a lot of times I find sometimes with my busy schedule that I just don't have the time to do it. And there's nothing I want to do more than bust out that mash tun. But then when I'm thinking, all right, I'm going to be going till 2 or 3 in the morning and I'm going to be losing a lot of sleep, or I can just put another pot in on the stove while I'm making the kids dinner and make beer while I'm doing that. And it's nice to be able to have that, the convenience of that as well.
You're a multitasker. The macaroni and cheese and the homebrew at the same time.
Mac and cheese over here. You got your porter over here.
So. That's pretty a glowing endorsement for malt extract.
But a lot of people do, you know, start with the extract. And we started as extract brewers, but then I like to think that we graduated a little bit to the world of all grain brewing. Because, I mean, I know I speak for me. Obviously, I need some more less of this. But when you're doing all grain, I mean, it's really neat to be able to do all that and to take all the different styles and options. There's so much more you can do with an all grain batch, and to me, that's why I like all grain better. But I love having the convenience of extract to fall back on.
Yeah. Bottom line is there's plus and minuses to both.
Exactly.
And you have to decide whether you are more interested in doing malt extract or if you want to go through the extra work of doing all grain.
Just find what works for you. But it's neat. I think that starting as an extract brewer has made me a better all grain brewer, to learn about the processes and everything that goes into it, and you know, everything from temperature control, you know, all the way through the process. So there are definitely pros and cons to each, as Scott said.
Yeah, that's true. Taking those baby steps initially allows you to really appreciate the differences once you get up to all grain.
True that, bro. All right, there it is. Extract, all grain. We're the Scotts and Bull City Homebrew. Thanks for watching.